Today we shall talk about the structure of commercial banking in India. The structure of commercial banking in India has been defined in two broad groups. That is, there are two broad heads under which the commercial banks are divided. They are number A, scheduled banks, and number B, non-scheduled banks. So let's see what are scheduled banks. Scheduled bank refers to those banking institutions whose names were included in the second schedule of the Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. So, all those banks which are included under the RBI Act of 1934 can be defined as the scheduled bank. And the conditions that are to be followed by a banking institution in order to be included on this act are: the paid up capital and reserves of the bank should not be less than rupees 5 lakhs. That is, minimum reserves which are to be maintained is rupees 5 lakhs. The bank must satisfy the Reserve Bank that its affairs are not conducted in a manner which is detrimental to the interest of the depositors. Or in other words, if someone saves in the bank, it should be beneficial to the savers, not harmful. Number 3. The bank must be a corporation or cooperative society and not a partnership or single owner firm. That is, the bank must be a partnership, but a cooperation of certain group of people. So these three conditions should be fulfilled, then only you become a scheduled bank. There are three categories of scheduled banks. They are the scheduled commercial banks, which are in India as well as foreign banks, includes, for example, the normal commercial banks like the SBI, the Canara Bank, the Punjab National Bank, etc. Whereas foreign banks includes your Deutsche Bank, Bank of England, Bank of America, etc. Number 2, scheduled state cooperative banks. They are the banks which are run in the cooperative level and on the state level. For example, Apex Bank. And the last one is the regional rural banks, which is the banks which are based in rural area, and every state has their own rural banks. So these are what scheduled banks is made up of. Now, what are the benefits or privileges of a scheduled bank? If a bank is scheduled bank, what kind of benefits or privileges does it enjoy? So they are covered by the Deposit Insurance and Credit Guarantee Scheme. They are also eligible for obtaining loans at bank rate from the Reserve Bank. The scheduled banks also automatically acquire the membership of clearing house, etc. Then also, more than this, they are able to discount the bills of exchange, and also they receive free finance facility. So these are the privileges which a scheduled banks are able to obtain. Okay, so another important thing is that all the activities of the scheduled banks are monitored by and controlled by legally the central bank, which is the Reserve Bank of India. So the scheduled banks operate under strict supervision of the Reserve Bank and are required to follow the guidelines issued by the Reserve Bank from time to time. So these are the qualities, or we can say these are the points which makes up a scheduled bank. Then the next broad group under which a commercial bank is differentiated or divided is non-scheduled banks. Now, what are non-scheduled banks? Non-scheduled banks are those banks whose names have not appeared in the list of banks maintained by the Reserve Bank. Okay, so we just beforehand explained that according to the RBI Act of 1934, all those banks which are scheduled in those lists are scheduled banks. On the other hand, the banks which are not listed in that act are known as your non-scheduled banks. However, these banks come within the sweep of the Banking Regulation Act 1949 and are therefore obliged to follow the Reserve Bank's guideline and provisions of the Act. For instance, these banks are also required to have a minimum capital of rupees 5 lakhs. So, non-scheduled banks are those banks which come under the list of the Act, Banking Regulation Act, that is 1941, 49. So, they are not available, two available, so they are not getting such privileges which the scheduled banks are getting. For example, non-scheduled banks are not eligible for having financial assistance from the RBI under emergency situation. Also, they are mostly deprived of the benefits which a scheduled bank enjoys. So, the non-scheduled banks are engaged in lending money, discounting and collecting bills and other various agency functions. But right now, the Reserve Bank of India does not encourage the opening up of non-scheduled banks. That is, they do not want that non-scheduled banks should be opened in our country. There are only four non-scheduled banks currently operating in our country.